Hi, this is a review for the movie Animal, a film that is neither entertaining nor has anything to say, the cinematic equivalent of a teenager having a hormonal temper tantrum. Hey all, my name is Sucharita. Welcome back to the channel where we talk about movies and occasionally with people making the movies. Aaj we've got the Ranbir Kapoor, Anil Kapoor, Rashmika Mandanna starrer Animal, edited, directed and co-written by Sandeep Reddy Vanga. Ranbir Kapoor is Ranvijay, who, as you probably surmised from the trailer, has everything money can buy, except his father's love and attention. Never mind his poor mum enabling his bad behavior, all Vijay wants is to be able to spend his father Balbir's birthdays with him. Again, mother, very much alive and standing around looking sad. Inconsequential. Now, denied this love, Vijay slowly turns into an animal with uncontrollable instinct, acting upon every single intrusive thought in his man brain. Also, because Balbir is the richest or one of the richest men in India, nothing Vijay does, including straight up mass murder, has any legal consequences. Law enforcement? We don't know her. So the film takes place in flashback. I tried to figure out why I couldn't. The first scene is a prosthetically aged Ranbir Kapoor in the year 2056, telling a group of men an Aineen story about a monkey in a jungle. But like, just like this scene, much of Animal screenplay presents sequence upon gory sequence purely for the shock value they provide. Look, violence for violence's sake, sexism for sexism's sake, declarations of masculinity only because one can. Sadly, it's a man's world, Vijay says to his wife in a scene without a hint of awareness. You don't have to tell us twice. The entire film illustrates that it is in a man's world, using as many bullets and murders as it can. It's not a lament like Nikhil Nagesh Bhatt's ultra-violent Kill that premiered at TIFF, where violence is portrayed as a way of showing the trappings of masculinity, or that you have to resort to your manhood as a tool when all else fails, the one thing that gives you an automatic advantage in the world regardless of your social status. In Kill, Raghav Joyal and his men murder on a train because it's the only option they are left with to gather wealth in a system that doesn't work for them. In Animal, Vijay is violent because no one booked him a psych eval as a teenager. In this slasher movie, men protect the honor of their families as real men must, using swords, axes and guns. Enough references are made to penises and body hair to underline this declaration.
Papa. Papa.
Sunai de raha hai, behra nahi hoon main.
Anil Kapoor is Balbir, a businessman so preoccupied with his empire, he seemingly doesn't even retaliate or care upon realizing a teacher at school has physically assaulted his son. While the actor is, you know, very good at his job, especially in the yelly scenes where he tries to parent his enfant terrible. Aside from this though, the character is a ping pong ball bouncing around a screenplay that's desperately trying to justify its protagonist's rage with some semblance of a reason why it is translating so murderous. When Balbir is not yelling vocational platitudes like, I run a business across three time zones, he sits behind an office desk, silently simmering, allowing his progeny to rain hell, clearing his conscience with the occasional, I don't agree with your methods. As Ranbir Kapoor enters the film, interrupting yet another wedding with yet another embarrassing song performance, a sort of fourth wall breaks, reminding you how many times you've seen the actor do this before. Almost like reading our minds, the film then goes, aha! You think you know Ranbir, huh? Now let me show you what your wildest imagination could not have anticipated.
You're fighting ghosts in your head. Do you even realize that?
Main ghosts se ladta nahi, unhe kha jata hu.
Now that's what Animal boils down to. Intending to provoke snowflakes and opinionated critics of Vanga's last outing, Kabir Singh, very carefully picking out commentary on that film and giving it just a little bit of a twist. So you were concerned at men applauding when Kabir slapped Preeti? Sure, Vijay will never slap his wife Gitanjali, played by Rashmika. She will slap him. So when you bring up Vijay's misogyny, these slaps can be invoked. Oh, you didn't like how Kabir debased Preeti? Look how Gitanjali now debases herself. It's almost like Vijay fancies himself as a Napoleonic king. There's a scene in both Ridley Scott's recent Napoleon and Animal where this conqueror returns home to his nubile attractive wife and makes her take her clothes off in front of the house help, presenting her body for him to admire and touch. While Ridley Scott's Napoleon is seen through a comedic lens, a pitiable fool who doesn't realize all his heinous actions are leading him towards an embarrassing end, Vanga's Vijay is heroic and tragic right up till the end, asking his audience to empathize with and love this sad, broken, but strong man who kills people because his father didn't cut a birthday cake or two.
He's the best father in the world. Don't ever go there.
No. I shall not and honestly cannot get into all the misogyny of this film, because anything a female film critic will have to say about this movie will be reduced to a feminist is just splitting hairs over a film. There is enough in the length here to be used as a counter. Oh, you don't like that he asked Tripti Dimri to lick his boots? But how about her plans? You didn't like how he treated his sisters, huh? So a brother shouldn't step in to protect his sisters? These aren't arguments that can be had, and frankly, getting involved with them takes focus away from the larger discussion I believe that we should have around the current climate of Hindi cinema that celebrates major movie stars and filmmakers coming together to propagate hot-tempered brutality as an acceptable or perhaps the only way of attaining justice. Wickedness masquerading as goodness. I wondered if the script and story of this film were arcless and pointless for a reason. Stitched mostly episodically, Animal never crescendos because its protagonist is almost always very consistently flat. Angry. When at school, a digitally de-aged Ranbir Kapoor shoots an AK-47 style assault weapon and drives boys off the road in his car, the rage in his small frame is proportionate to that in his bulkier figure in the climactic shirtless fight with Bobby Deol. From Delhi to Scotland, the journey is only external, not internal. Ranbir Kapoor is angry in the first scene, he's angry in the last. Animal is not written to present finesse in cinematic storytelling, character development, subplot, conflict, catharsis or pathos. The film is a 3.5 hour long bait for cultural commentators. It's almost sad, really. The craft of filmmaking is sacrificed for clamorous scenes where a group of masked men appear at a hotel to kill Vijay right at he's in another room doing an arms deal, means har tarah ka weapon uske paas hai. The seemingly old boy inspired corridor axe fighting sequence is overlaid with dexterity over Bhupinder Babbal singing Arjan Vaile, and it looks magnificent. But that's all it is, shock value. I did wonder what the mask budget of the opposing team was, and why the foot soldiers kept their masks on as their ringleader, the most important guy who must conceal his identity, immediately takes his off. Did they all have trial fittings before being sent into action? 200 of them on their way to kill one man?
Baba, ye to shuruaat hai. Bahut kaam baki hai, Baba.
Animal doesn't exist in a reality you and I know and can perceive. But neither is it convincing as a purely fantastical, melodramatic Bollywood film where disbelief must be suspended. When Vijay, in another fit of rage, kills a prominent man and all his stooges with about 100 eyewitnesses in the middle of a conference, orchestrating what can only be described as a massacre, it is barely referenced again in the film. The writing is uninterested in tying loose ends or satisfactorily culminating subplots. So all I'm taking from this is, India mein ultra-rich can get away with not just murder, but wholesale slaughter. And don't come for me now saying why I must invoke this India thing. The film invites you to look at its protagonist as a sort of ghar mein ghus ke marenge new age Indian man. Something you've heard Hindi cinema espouse before. Background score is pointedly halted during a havan scene for Gitanjali to ask Vijay to drink cow urine, which he promptly does. During a fight sequence, a hybrid lawnmower-esque bullet machine is emblazoned with made in India. Upendra Limai, as a jumpy arms dealer Freddy, proudly proclaims his weapons are an example of Atmanir Bharat, yelling salute the champion after Vijay achieves his Vijay using said weapons. On the contrary, the bad guy, played by Bobby Deol, is Abrar Haq, a Muslim with 3 wives. As he murders someone during his 3rd wedding, right in the introduction scene, in the sequence after, he summons all 3 of his wives in his bedroom, proceeding to violently rip their clothes off, giving the men in the audience a quick chuckle. In the bare-chested climactic sequence between Vijay and Abrar, the men decide to fight one-on-one. As their bodies collide, Biprak's voice echoes, Papa mujhe aapka na hona maar dega. If it weren't so unintentionally hilarious, I would have been more impressed with the frankly genius casting of Bobby Deol as Ranbir Kapoor's long estranged cousin. Identical twins, a man watching half observes. Yeah, I buy it. But despite the gore, heavily underlined machismo and provocative sexism, Animal is simply desperately dull. One could appreciate Amit Roy's love for Ranbir Kapoor's face and the close-ups he shoots off him. The dexterity of Vanga's match cuts in the edit and Harshvardhan Rameshwar's precise background scoring. But at 201 minutes, all of it blurs into a cacophony of blasts and blasphemy. Like I said, the treatment of women, mother, sister, girlfriend, wife, it's all a bait the film wants you to rise to. Gitanjali forgives her husband's atrocious disregard for her because he stood by her as she delivered his children. As she admonishes him for smoking in the middle of a church after he's had heart surgery, he shoves his iPods in her ears in response, where she can hear the two of them having sex for the first time, a recording he's managed to... Immediately, her anger fades and she's turned on. call it what you will, Animal is not dishonest. Vijay goes so far as to tell his son he's a movie director. And yet, despite seeing the filmmaker almost appear in his passionate but applesauce screenplay, the film fails to hold your attention beyond the midway mark. It itself sort of deflates as it runs out of space to add even more half-cooked mini-narratives. Characters have sudden changes of heart, tears are shed, hugs are shared, little of which translates as things should in the third act of a film, because now your brain is numb from the assault of everything that has come before. There will be as many reactions to reviews of the film as there will be to the film itself. One can safely assume interviews will begin in a few days, arming fan armies and social media trolls with fresh vocabulary to use on X, formerly known as Twitter. There will be more noise on more platforms decrying opinion, calling critics woke feminists. Perhaps this might be the actual conversation one should be having around cinema as it exists in 2023, an expectation to adhere to a manufactured status quo. Actors and filmmakers will appear in year-end roundtables now, politely saying, oh, everybody's entitled to their opinion, as their social media armies will work overtime to verbally abuse dissenting opinion into oblivion. The film will make a ton of money as nameless, faceless folks descend in droves in our mentions, in our comments, with threats in the most colorful language. An audience invigorated, activated. One can take pride in their work, but look around and see, are they taking responsibility?
I surely wish you'd die that day.
So on a scale of 1 to 10, Animal is... One scene may even Shakti Kapoor looks sort of surprised at the excessive bloodlust. Go watch the movie and tell me in the comments what you think. Subscribe to my channel before you leave. My name is Sacharita. I really want to get to that 100,000. Thank you for stopping by.